Hello traders and investors, welcome back to the Trend Trader channel. Once again, we are looking at the most anticipated earnings for this week. There's a lot of companies that we're going to be going through, or there's a lot of companies that will be releasing their earnings. However, we are only going to focus on the 10 companies. Of those companies, we are simply talking technical analysis. Obviously, the earnings report will affect how the market react to those companies, and they will drive the share prices in certain direction. The stocks can either go up or down depending on how the market interpret the news that are coming from those companies. And before we start, I would like to ask those people who are viewing this channel for the first time to please consider subscribing. You will help us grow the channel. And if you find value in this video, please make sure that you smash the like button. So the first company that we want to look at today is PLTR. We saw that like any other company in the market, it has had a series of up and down. But now what attracts us to PLTR, you can already see that the stock is in a nice uptrend. It broke above this level. And then as you can see, there has been a couple of series where the stock will move up and then retrace a bit and then break above that level and continue to find a support on its way upward. You can also see that the stock is creating a series of a higher low. So each new low on a pullback is higher than the previous low. So based on just technical analysis alone, we are looking at this area. We see that during that pullback, the stock found support on this rising key moving average. And where it is at this moment, you see that previously we covered the stock. This was our level of interest. So at that time, we wanted to see if PLTR can find a support level somewhere here, of which it failed and it only found support on this key moving average. However, the stock is now back above this support level. So anywhere above this level, that is where we are interested. Again, based on technical analysis, taking the earnings report aside, this could be an ideal point of entry with the stop loss just below this level. Otherwise, if you want to wait for the earnings, you can also consider this level to wait and see as the news are coming after hours on Monday. Then you can see how the stock is going to react on those news. Obviously, if the price break above $26, that is another entry opportunity that you can use there. So anytime between $24 and $26 is a potential entry. However, for a continuous price continuation or confirmation of the continuation on share price, you can consider buying after the stock has closed above $26. So that is just a PLTR in a nutshell. Another stock with a similar setup is Disney. So again, we're always going to look for companies that are in the stage 2 analysis. You can see that there was that a breakout on this level with a retest there, and the stock is trying to come back above this support level. However, do be mindful of the gap between the key moving average and where the share price it is currently at. Again, where the price is currently at around $114, that is an ideal entry level. But since we're expecting earnings, we can also take this level into consideration. Again, waiting for the price to break above this level to give us a nice confirmation that the price is ready to move up. However, as you know, if you buy a breakout somewhere around 125, then your stop loss need to be somewhere just below this breakout level, so that at all times you trade with a favorable risk to reward ratio. But as things stand, this is what we see in terms of the Walt Disney Company. Another stock that people talk about, remember, even though we're only covering technical analysis, you should also look at the fundamentals of these companies, see if the company is growing its revenue, sales and profit, and if they are growing those earnings per share, because those are the other key factors that also do move the share price up. In this channel, for now, we are just simply talking about technical analysis, but there's always more than other things that you need to take into consideration, not just technical analysis alone. So what we see here, we see Celsius. This was the previous level that we're keeping an eye on. You see there was that nice breakout there, and then there is a retest again. For those people who haven't seen the video where we talk about a break and retest strategy, we're gonna leave that video in the description. It's a short video, it's about 2 to 3 minutes, and it quickly covers this strategy and why this strategy is profitable, and that is one of the reasons why we have been trading this strategy with success for a very long time. So where we are, again, we are here at a bounce. This is another opportunity, a nice opportunity to buy the stock as soon as it found a support here with the stop just somewhere around $65 in anticipation that the share price is going to go up. Obviously, during the course of the week, we might see the stock, especially if it comes with a positive news and people are buying the stock, because it's not just about positive or negative news. It is about people acting on that particular kind of news. So again, this is the other level where we will be looking to continue to add on that position, especially if you have bought either around $70 or where the share price it is currently at. Remember, at all times we talk about placing a stop loss, because you will never know, the price can just break above a level and then pull back to close again below that level, and then putting you in a negative position. So at all times, you should think risk management first. Don't just jump into the stock and hope for the best. A lot of things can happen in the market. Okay. Now let us look at Datadog again. This is a stock that we covered some time ago. We traded the stock, but at that time the stock did not move as fast as we wanted to see it move. Basically, we're looking at this level. We're expecting that the stock was just gonna continue to trade further up there, since it broke above this level. However, instead of continuing to move up, you can see the stock reached a new high there, not a new high, a 52 week high, because you can see on this side there's that high somewhere around $160 per share. So since then the stock just kept on bouncing. This level you can see now it's like it's retracing back down there. So we will see if it is going to come back to bounce at this level. Where we're interested in the stock, we're interested in the stock as soon as it break above this level. This is where we want to put our buy order. If you want to set a trade so that you don't spend all the time looking at the chart, you can just set a buy stop order around this level, so that when it is triggered you will be in the trade. Obviously then you will need to have a stop loss just below this level here. This is on an assumption that the stock can break above this level, but if it breaks below this level, then we are no longer interested in going long, or we are no longer interested in buying this particular company. Remember, if we don't buy a stock based on technical analysis, it does not mean that the company is bad in terms of fundamental analysis or other things that you may want to take into consideration. It is just our opinion that we prefer to put our capital on companies that are trending higher rather than stocks that are trending lower. And also remember, here we are coming with a trading mindset, not with an investing mindset. So if you have a investor's mindset, then what we share here might disagree with some of the things that you believe in, especially when it comes to the stock market. Okay, now looking at Ferrari. Well, here Ferrari is listed in New York Security Exchange, but remember this is an Italian company, so it trades during the European time, because it trades in the Eurostock. I'm not sure if there's an Italian stock market, but there should be. But we are looking at the ADR that is trading in the US. So at this moment we have a position. In fact, we started buying Ferrari when it broke above this level, and we have been adding on that position. You can see when that breakout happened here, somewhere around this level. The stock broke above this level, it traded higher, it came back to retest this level before it attempted to move up, of which at this time it broke above this level. So now this is our next area of value. This is where we are looking at the stock to see how the stock is going to behave. Obviously, you've been watching this video enough now. You know that you are anticipating a breakout above this level, and that is where we are going to add on to our existing position. However, something that you should keep in mind, if the stock does break above this level, remember that we're also tracking this key moving average. So there are two potential support level. Obviously, is this level of this key moving average, and also this level here. This level around $400 is closer to 480. However, the gap between 480 and 380, it is a big gap. So when people talk about extended stocks, they are talking about something that looks like this. So whenever you jump into a stock, always try to identify levels where the stock might go to if the upward move does not work out, and then see how big is that gap and see if you can handle that gap financially and emotionally. Because remember, as soon as you buy a position at 48, 41 and the stock starts to move against you, it moves against you on your capital, you start to see red in your portfolio, and that potential loss, it keeps on widening, and that can easily take a toll on you emotionally. So don't just be excited about a position, but also it is important that you manage that position very well, so that at all times you remain sharp in the market. Okay, now let us look at this network stock, the granddaddy of internet, which is Arista Network. Some people have been trading this name. We don't have a position yet, but for obvious reason, you can see the stock, it came back to find a support at this level, and then it is starting to bounce up. So these are the potential trade levels that we're looking at. This level here, so that is where we want to see how the stock is going to behave. Obviously, we want to see if the stock does find resistance at this level, or if it finds a resistance here, and then the ultimate goal is that the stock breaks above this level, and then there's a possibility that it can continue with its nice upward movement there. Remember, when you're in a position and the stock is trending higher, you just sit in that position. Some of these companies, they pay dividends, and you will be getting capital appreciation, but you'll also be receiving a dividend payment from those particular companies. But if you buy a stock that is on a downward movement, you could be receiving a dividend, but if the stock, it starts to break lower, then that dividend is like it is taken back. So that is why we just want to buy the stock that are in sync with the general market. By that we mean we want those companies that are trending higher, because that is where there is an opportunity to make money. There's nothing that is easy in the market, but we just want to try to make it as easy as possible for us to make money in the stock market. And then let us look at Uber Technologies. I just want to make sure that my chart is in a log scale. I prefer to look at my chart in the log scale, because any difference between those between 2 points in terms of percentages, it is the same difference, even though in terms of the price it could be a big difference. But yeah, that is just how I like to see my chart. I like to see it in a log scale. Yes, now it is in a log scale. Okay, so again, we are looking at this level here. As you can see, there's just a similar theme on what we want to trade and what we're expecting of those companies. Even here on Uber, we can buy at the current level at 69, however keeping a stop loss just below this level in case the share price break below this level. And then again, we can anticipate the share price of Uber to come and retest this level with the possibility of breaking above this level. And this is one of the reasons why we like technical analysis, because the patterns are repetitive. We don't have to worry ourselves much about the company, any company, not just Uber, because each and every company has its own way of doing things. They've got other things that can affect the company. But at the end of the day, in terms of price action, we are trading the same price action over and over again, and it has been profitable in the past, and we expect it to continue to be profitable. Now let us look at Shopify. We don't know if people are still excited about Shopify, but in terms of technical analysis, there is a breakout that happened around November 2023. The stock attempted to trade higher, creating this new high or 52-week high at that time, before the stock it pulled back again to come and retest this previous breakout level. Automatically, we're expecting the share price. We can already see that it did find support on the rising moving average, which is good. Then we're expecting the share price to come back to retest this high at some point, and then during that retest and then a potential close above that $88, then we can expect the share price to continue to go up. So what we normally do, we'll create a watch list of the stocks that we intend to trade, so that from time to time we can go back to that list to see. Or if you can set an alert, you can just set an alert that if Shopify breaks above $88, like maybe $88.10, $88.50, then you can go back to the chart and then come back to trade your plan, because it is important that you plan your trades, but it's even more important that you trade your plan, because that is the only way that you can make money in the stock market. So the second last stock that we are looking at is Affirm Holdings. Again, same thinking with Shopify. We see a nice pullback to that potential support level. We see the stock it attempted to trade higher, even though the volume is not as big. Ideally, we would have wanted to see this large volume, because that will tell us that more and more people are buying the stock, but the volume is a bit thin. So we'll see during the course of the week if the volume is going to increase, and then we'll consider buying the stock when it breaks above this level. Remember, even though we prefer to trade the horizontal support level, other people, they also prefer to trade things that looks like a trend line, so that they can get an early entry and then have their stop loss just somewhere below it. And then you can see that there's still a level that you can trade. Like if you look, this is going to be your risk and this is going to be your potential reward. So you can start making money, assuming the share price go up before that breakout happens. So in the market, there are so many ways that you can make money. There isn't just a single way. However you do it, you just need to be consistent and manage risk as you go about with that kind of trading. And then lastly, the stock that we're going to be looking at is Duolingo. We covered it again in some of the previous week. This one is nice. We like the setup as it is, without even thinking about the earnings report. We can see that the stock is already at this level. So for us, the stock is ready for a breakout. It found support here. It found a support here. Obviously, nothing is guaranteed. The stock can still easily come back to $200. And worst case scenario, it can even trade below $200. But where it is at the moment, it shows us that the stock, people have been accumulating it, and they're trying to push the share price up and want to participate in that particular company. So yeah, that's it for this week. We covered 10 companies in terms of technical analysis. but there's plenty of other companies that will be coming out with their earnings report. They might do way better than the stocks that we covered, but we don't want to have a video that goes for like an hour. We believe that covering about 10 companies that have potential trade levels is also beneficial to the viewers and subscribers. And again, if you appreciate this video and you haven't subscribed, please consider subscribing and make sure that you smash that like button. If you have any comments or suggestion, please leave them in the comment section. We will see you in the next video.